starting from the IPAS study, we identified EGFR mutation as the biomarker for personalized medicine. But within a short decade, we actually from one gene to actually now we have 10 genes that we need to know for the proper management of the lung cancer patient. So it's exciting, and we need to incorporate that into so-called the frontline testing. But this is just the beginning. I think in the future development, I think there's a big space on the resistance. Now, patients who have already received the first generation or second generation or third generation EGFR TKI, when they become resistant, we probably need to know what happened genomically. Now, for example, we have a MEK amplification that we can utilize, a MEK inhibitor. We may also look for the C797S and proper others. So to integrate the space of resistance, we actually need to know more genomic information and then hopefully develop further therapy. So that is on resistance. But moving to the earlier stage, we probably have the question of whether we can apply MRD in the clinical usage. Now, patients with resected lung cancer, adjuvant therapy is now in part of the management. But who may benefit more? Who we must have give the treatment? So MRD hopefully will give us a little bit more information. Now coming even earlier is for the early detection. With further refinement of the early detection technology, such as fragmentomic, then hopefully we can apply it for actually the general population. Now, it's not just the smoker population, but rather the non-smoker population. Maybe we can use a simple blood test to rule out lung cancer as early detection. So I think the field is exciting, from early detection all the way to resistant. There's a big landscape.